Hey guys, I'm Ryan from Yellow Card, and I'm here with the Swallow Sisters. They're going to be here all day at Warped Tour, so stay tuned. Everywhere I go, it's a matter of fact.
Hey guys, it's Captain Swallow here.
And I'm Sarah Swallow.
And we're behind the scenes at 2016 Vans Warped Tour. We're here with Ballyhoo.
Hey, woo!
So just introduce yourself and what you do.
My name's Howie and I sing and play guitar for the band.
Awesome.
I'm Scott and I play keys and turntables.
And so where are you guys from?
Baltimore, Aberdeen, Maryland.
Aberdizzle. Yep.
How'd you guys meet? Was it in Maryland or how'd you?
High school. We actually all went to high school together.
Actually, we went to middle school together.
Middle school? Middle school.
Were you friends in middle school though?
Yeah, a little bit.
A little bit. We knew each other. I didn't like this guy.
Separate homeroom.
Yeah. Who would? No. Oh, shit. Okay, I see that.
High school is when it all came together.
Yeah. Wow, you should definitely. So, did one of you just play or say you're starting a band? How did that happen?
The drummer is my brother, and he and I started our band in our mom's basement, and we needed
classic band.
Exactly, yeah. So we needed like band members, so I figured the easiest thing was to have people at school, and everybody was into music, you know, so just kind of did it from there.
That's cool. That's a good environment. Mine wasn't like... Now, if you could describe your band's musical style in only two words, what would it be?
Punk rock, reggae sex music.
Okay, I said two, but that's fine. Yeah, okay. Yeah, if you just kind of mold them together, totally, okay.
You just say punk rock, reggae sex music.
Wow, that was one word even. Oh, wow, okay. Yes, one up to him right there. How'd you guys get the name of the band, Ballyhoo?
We had a friend who was goofy like us when we were kids, and she said, hey, you should name your band Ballyhoo, because we were kids when we started. We were like 14, so. And it just stuck, and it sounded like big and colorful. So.
And the rest was history, wasn't it? Check that out. I'm loving it.
Tight.
How's been playing Warped Tour so far for you guys?
Amazing.
It's awesome. It's been a blast. Hot, but it's been fun.
Got a lot of homies out. We got Pepper. We got Real Big Fish, Less Than Jake. It's amazing. A lot of friends.
That's awesome. Now, what is your favorite moment of this Warped Tour so far?
My favorite so far was side stage watching Real Big Fish play. Old school, you know, the guy's been around forever. And seeing Chris from Motionless in White, who was obviously a very dark music, dark band, coming up side stage and singing every word along with the Real Big Fish. I thought that was amazing.
That's really touching. How about you?
That's rad. Yeah, that's more touching than what I'm gonna say.
Yours just getting like fucked up, or?
Yeah, just getting fucked up every now and then. That's pretty much it. Yeah. It's cool like meeting new people that haven't heard of us before, and you know, just kind of getting that. Oh my God, you're my new favorite band. So. Yeah.
Yeah, that happens to me and Kat too. We have like a two-person band. It's Swallow Sisters. It's a shower band only, so we just kind of sing from there, and the fans kind of stand outside. It's kind of creepy, actually.
Now you're making it sound.
Yeah. So, have you guys had any embarrassing moments, or are you not going to share it with us? Or if you just
specifically, or just in general?
And in general, what's the worst?
I mean, plenty.
since you got out of the womb, or
like too many to like think about.
What's your top thing? It's gotta be something embarrassing.
Oh man.
Do you have anything you're saving?
Embarrassing to happen to you.
Is it the fact that you can't answer this question right now?
Might be pretty embarrassing. Usually I'm pretty witty, but not today.
So I heard you guys, you had an off night last night. Did I hear that correctly?
Yeah.
And how did you spend it?
In a hotel parking lot, riding skateboards, and writing songs.
I found a craft beer bar right next door and enjoyed delicious beers all day.
Yeah,
craft beer bar.
It doesn't sound great, but I thought you guys were reading books by a fireplace. That's fine. It was probably just me.
On occasion, nice glass of scotch, a cigar.
You'll delve into some Fitzgerald or something of that sort. So, if you guys were on a deserted island, you can only bring two items with you. What are you going to bring?
Lube and a box of tissues.
You know, we've actually gotten similar answers, so I want to say I'm surprised, but I'm not.
I think it was from Real Big Fish, actually. So.
And what about you?
I hope I don't end up on the same island as this guy.
Oh my God.
An acoustic guitar. Shit.
You're on an island and you play and there's no one there to hear it. Did you really play at all?
All right. Are we really here at all in the first place? Let's delve deeper into this. Shit, man. Yeah, my acoustic guitar and sunscreen.
Awesome. You're prepared.
Yeah.
Do you guys have any hidden talents?
That you can talk about in public? Or?
I'm very loud about my talents. I make sure everyone knows what I can do. I don't know.
So it's just playing this band. It's just nothing special. Yeah. Just the usual stuff.
I like to draw.
My hidden.
Yeah.
I like to draw, you know, on the side, and I'm artsy guy.
Did you design the flag? Oh, it's dope.
Design a tattoo, and yeah.
Do you have any tats?
I don't. Yeah.
Nothing? Oh, tame.
So boring.
Okay, so, who are you going to vote for president? I'm going to give you some options. Clinton, Trump, or Kevin Lyman?
Kevin Lyman.
Kevin Lyman for pres, for sure.
Good choice, gentlemen. Dreams come true.
Hell yeah. Kevin Lyman for president.
Kevin Lyman for president. Everybody go vote. You can write him in. You don't have to vote for who's there. You can write in whoever the fuck you want.
That's a money shot. If we all here write it in, there's a chance.
Everyone at Warped Tour writes it in on election day. Kevin Lyman for president.
No. No, these are pretty special to my heart.
Yeah.
Swallow Twins lighters.
Swallow.
Twins lighters.
Love it.
And what do you think about that?
I think that's amazing.
Which one do you like better, though?
It's obvious, but...
Gonna go with the Twins.
Yeah, okay. I can't wait to smoke a bowl with it later.
Perfect.
Kevin Lyman's
oh, thank
second.
You. You're flattering me now. So what do you guys think about Warped Tour giving, you know, media outlets that aren't as, like, famous or popular, independent, I guess, the chance to do their thing and do interviews? What do you think about that?
I think it goes right along with everything Kevin is about. Like, it's all about giving a spotlight to the underdog, and the press is no different. So he's given, like, you know, small time, I should say, I guess, independent journalists, whatever, a chance to kind of meet these bigger bands and get their stuff out there. You know what I mean? I think it's a great, great thing.
That's awesome. Do you have anything to add?
What he said.
Everything he said. Like you said, I think it's really cool. It goes back with what you were saying, how people have never heard you and they're hearing you say new favorite band. I love that. That's really great about Warped Tour.
Same.
Yeah, amazing. So, Zombie Apocalypse, okay? You have to kill off one band because I guess they're turning into zombies.
You gotta feed them.
Okay, you have to feed one band to the zombies. Who are you feeding them?
On Warped Tour?
Yes.
Ooh, Warped Tour. I would feed them pepper because they're scrumptious.
Oh, that's really kind.
They're delicious.
They're tasty. They're tasty gentlemen.
That dark meat?
I would feed them the band with the most members to give us the most time to run away.
You'd have to bury pepper first in the sand and then dig them back up, though. You'd have to have a luau style.
You have a whole plan.
Yeah,
that's a tactical answer, what you said there. The quantity, that's really great for the zombies. Take some time. Yep, really great. Now, if you could team up with a band, are you going solo? You teaming up? What are you doing?
To fight the zombies?
Of course. You know, you're going to join the zombies. What are you doing?
Real Big Fish has power numbers. Power numbers.
They've, yeah. It would have to be a ska band. I think Les and Jake and Real Big Fish would be key for fighting
all
the zombies.
All the horns can definitely be used as axes and weapons.
Would be good as well because they already have their head on about it. They're like, yes. Look, guys, assuming we survive.
Honestly, they'll probably give you the warning that the zombies are here, and then that's when you'll know.
They will, that's right.
So it's been awesome talking to you guys. You guys rock. So remind us when and where you're playing.
We're coming back to Boston. We're going to be at Paradise Rock Club on September 24th, but we got a tour starting with Zach Deputy and Bumpin' Uglies in September. We're going to be going up and down the East Coast, so come say what's up. Check it at ballyhoorocks.com and all the social medias.
Awesome. Thanks, guys. Have a good day.
Yeah.